Terve! Welcome everyone to this brand new video on this brand new channel, Pelkä Tyhmä Hurri, which is my second channel, or fifth, but anyway, it's not my main channel, but I took all my videos talking about Finnish and Finland and put it here on this new channel because I'm a weird Swede. I love languages and everyone says that Finnish is such a hard language to learn, which I don't agree with at all. But I thought the time was right to learn Finnish. I started to learn Finnish. I started to find stuff to talk about. So I started to make videos about it. And now every other video is about Finland and Finnish, so I thought, let's make a new channel, put everything on here, and if you're interested in this, you can subscribe to only this channel. Today, I wanted to talk a little bit about why I'm learning puhekieli, and this seems to be something that not all Finns agree with me about, and it's something I think should be taught even more than it is today. So, if you didn't know, we could divide Finnish into two separate languages or similar languages. One is the standard Finnish, kirjakieli, book language, or the standard Finnish that you would see in writing or when I think talking on TV and radio and like what you usually use a standard language for. However, it's very archaic at times, and it has been preserved, let's say that. So, if you know, if we talk about Icelandic, for instance, among the Germanic languages, Icelandic is very Old Norse-y still. That's the same for Finnish. It's still very Finnic, so to speak. But then we have puhekieli, which most people speak. And it's some kind of a semi-standard. It's like parts of dialects that have been spreading and used by the majority, basically. So it's a semi-standard, semi-dialect. It's a bit hard to explain, but it's basically how the majority speaks with a dash of their dialect in it and so on. And I decided to start learning puhekieli first, or basically I'm learning maybe 80-20, like 80% puhekieli, 20% kirjakieli, because I do want to be able to read as well or know what some of those puhekieli words are abbreviation of, etc., etc., etc. But my focus, my main focus here is on puhekieli, the spoken Finnish. And it seems like not all Finns agree with this, and definitely the teachers or people writing books about Finnish, they don't even mention puhekieli, which is the weirdest thing to me, because to me this seems to be like more or less the real Finnish. And I know not all agree with me here, and you don't have to, but you don't learn kirjakieli as a child. You learn what your parents speak, so you will learn their dialect and some bits of puhekieli and so on. So really, you have to look at what is your purpose of learning Finnish. Do you want to become an author, best-selling author? The first thing you want to do, if you need to learn kirjakieli, maybe you really need that. But if you're a casual learner like me, the list would seem a bit different. So my list is like priority number one. I want to talk to people. I want to talk to people online, more or less, because I don't live in Finland. So, and my goal is not to move to Finland. I want to learn the language for speaking with Finns. And to me, it feels very awkward to go like minä olen, etc., instead of mä on. You know, it's just weird to me to speak like a book. it seems very weird to me. And when I listen to Finns, they don't really seem to speak like that either. So my main priority, my main goal is to learn spoken Finnish to speak with Finns. So that would be very logical, right? To learn that. And also, I'm a bit, you know, I really like to be able to pass as a native, at least until, like, to some extent, like 90% or something, I don't know. So I don't want to, basically, because of that, it wouldn't make sense for me to learn kirjakieli first. Second, I want to be able to consume content like YouTube videos or movies, TV shows, whatever. I want to be able to consume that in Finnish before be able to read. And I've heard that in Finnish, those things are something in between. So there is a continuum here. You go haywire, dialect, Finnish dialect, or you go kirjakieli on that part of the spectrum. And puhekieli is something in the middle, and TV shows and whatnot is something in the middle of that, or like in between puhekieli and kirjakieli, and dialect is, you know, puhekieli, and then it goes down to dialect. And I want to consume content made by Finns. I imagine that Finnish YouTubers wouldn't really speaking kirjakieli. It would be awkward, wouldn't it? Please agree with me here. It would be a bit awkward for people to be casual in kirjakieli. And yeah, then we start to come down to books or Wikipedia or whatever. There, you need to know kirjakieli. But my point here is that although those are kind of different languages in some aspect, like, or they are pretty different, those variations of Finnish, if you learn puhekieli, you would be able to comprehend what's in a book, even though you didn't learn kirjakieli first. Because you will still be able to deduce some things if you are that good at speaking Finnish generally. But it doesn't really work the other way around. You could compare this to Swedish and the Swedish reductions. Because if you learn Swedish like it's written, you would not learn the reductions, and we reduce a lot. Finns reduce at the end of some words, Swedes reduce in the middle of words, and smush words together and stuff. And if you want to understand someone from Sweden, I know that the Swedish speakers in Finland, they don't really do this, but if you want to survive in Sweden, you need to learn to understand these reductions. So, you would not learn that in school, you wouldn't learn that when reading a book, you wouldn't learn that at all. You need to practice your hearing, and same goes for kirjakieli. If you just learn that, you will have a hard time understanding Finns, because some of these, the aspects of puhekieli, some of those basically are that some words are very reduced or contracted. So you have tämä and you have tä. Instead, you have tule, but you have tu, and yeah, you get my point here. I wouldn't understand what tu is if I heard it and I had learned kirjakieli first. But the other way around, I know what that means, and from the context of what I'm reading, I would understand, I would go, ah, yes, of course, that's the long version of the word. So that's my take on this. It kinda works like, you can't learn You can't learn puekieli from learning kirjakieli, but the other way around, you could do that much more easily, because basically it has to do with reading and you have more time when you read to understand stuff. But if you listen to a Finn, you will be like, huh? Well, that's the Norwegians, they do that. Huh? The Swedes don't do that. But anyway, you would be very confused, all right? So that's my take on this. That's why I'm learning puekieli first. And I'm saying here that it makes sense to learn some kirjakieli at the same time. But for me, it's more like understand what the puekieli is about and understand what kind of changes there are there. So you could kind of learn them parallelly, but main focus is on spoken Finnish and not on standard Finnish, because you will have, if my priority is to understand how Finns speak, this is how I need to learn it. And if my focus is also to be able to pass as a Finn or seem casual or speak fluently like that, that's why I want to learn puekieli first. And like I said, if I pick up a book, I would, and I know the language well, I would most likely be able to get what it's about. And from the context, I would be able to learn that, oh, these bits are kirjakieli bits and so on. I might not be the best author, but I could learn it anyway later. Why not? But that's not my main focus. So hopefully this made a little bit of sense, and I just can't get why no one is teaching this, because this is really how the language is used and it's more organic like this. It's just very weird to me. Children, they learn puekieli, of course. They don't learn kirjakieli first, they learn how people speak. So basically, kirjakieli is this frozen language construct that hasn't changed much. And it's something you could learn in school later, which you do. So the same goes for other learners as well. I've heard that people struggle with understanding Finns when they are fluent in kirjakieli. So I don't want this to happen to me. I want to get fluent fast. Although I don't have much time to learn, so I'm like 1.5 year in and I haven't learned much, but still, I think this feels more natural. But I've come to realize that when I make a few examples in my videos, Finns react to that, and they feel it's weird that I do that in puekieli. So maybe, sure, why not? When it comes down to examples about language, maybe I should use kirjakieli instead. And I've noticed, I try to translate a book, I've noticed a few things that I'm not comfortable with, but I can, like I said, I can learn that later, because my main focus is speaking to Finns in a natural way. All right, hopefully this made a little bit of sense, and I would love to hear your take on this as well. I mean, this is how I want to do it, and so you can't really change my mind, and you don't really need to change my mind, because one way or the other, I will learn Finnish to some extent, and yeah, I just want to know how you feel about this, and what's your take on this. Maybe I missed something where it's very important to do it the other way around. But I'm a casual learner, I don't really need to learn Finnish, but I do it out of interest and curiosity. And hopefully this was a little bit, if you're learning Finnish, hopefully this was a little bit educational for you, or interesting for you to see my take on this and my priority list. And if you're a Finn, like I said, I would like to know how weird you feel that this approach is. And if you're a learner, how do you see, like, what's your list, what's your priorities when you're learning Finnish? So let me hear your take on this as well. Comment. down below. And remember to subscribe to this new channel. If you want more about Swede learning Finnish and stuff about Finland,